क्लास वन ऑफ मेजरमेंट्स लैब. यू कैन सी इन द इंडेक्स विच ऑल एक्सपेरिमेंट्स आर देयर इन योर सिलेबस. सी द रिमार्क्स कॉलम. नाउ देयर आर फ्यू इंस्ट्रक्शंस विच आर रिलेटेड विद द बेसिक्स which you have already studied in first year. In case you have doubt, you can kindly ask. All those points have been generalized in this topic. Now let us move to the first experiment. Potential transformer. Potential transformer or voltage transformer. Okay, it is also called as voltage transformer. It is used to measure high value of AC voltage. Okay. See experiment number 1B. Let us go to 1B first. So, a potential transformer is similar to a normal transformer, but it is always a step down transformer. Primary will have higher number of turns, secondary will have lesser number of turns. See, when you have to measure very high voltages, say 33 kV, 100 kV, 400 kV, etc., it is difficult or highly risky to connect a voltmeter to a high voltage circuit and measure, because for the operator to come near to the high voltage premises is dangerous. Also, manufacturing a high voltage, high range voltage, that is high voltage range voltmeter, is also costly. Hence, potential transformers are used in between the high voltage circuit and a voltmeter. So voltmeters will be of low range, say 300 volts or 1 kV, 2 kV, maximum say 10 kV. Now this experiment is regarding with to measure high voltage, to measure high AC voltage using low range voltmeter, normal voltmeter, and a PT. See, what PT will do is, forget about V1, there is no need of V1. Okay, this PT will step down. Suppose say here there is 10 kV, it will be stepped down to say 1 kV. Or 100 volts. Then this voltmeter can read the secondary voltage comfortably, then multiply by the turns ratio. If this is say this PT is 100:1, it means primary voltage is 100 times more than secondary voltage. Then the secondary reading, what you measure, that is to be multiplied by the turns ratio, or that is called as voltage ratio of the PT. We also call it as a PT ratio, potential transformer ratio. But normally
this will be very high and this will be low. Say this will be 100:1 or 1000:1. 100:1. Such a high ratio. But for laboratory purpose, that means for teaching students and for research purpose, we have just 2:1, that is 400:220 volts. See, here if it is 10 turns, this will be 5. This is 2:1. So show here number of turns is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here it should be 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. If possible, you can draw only 4 turns. Anyhow, don't bother so much. But primary number of turns should be more than secondary. See, PT is a normal potential transformer, is a normal transformer, but it cannot deliver load. You cannot connect here load in the secondary. Hence, its VA will be less. You can see here, only 15 VA. So the current in the wires or the coils will be very, very much less. Practically, theoretically it should be zero, but practically there will be magnetizing current, hence there will be some current. Okay, now how to measure? See, initially we will keep variac output at zero. You can see the table here. As we increase the output of variac, voltage applied to the potential transformer will also increase. Forget V1, there is no need of V1 in the experiment. There is no need, because V1 will be high voltage. We are measuring V1 with the help of V2 and PT ratio. If this is a 100, here it is 2:1, then what reading we get? V2, V2 multiplied by 2 will be equal to V1. So if there is no V1, you can calculate V1 just by reading V2 and multiply by 2, because this is 440 by 222. So here this will be low range voltmeter. Since this is 2:1, we will have here 300 volts, 150 volt. Okay. So keep on increasing variac output in steps. Note down both the meters in the table. So low range voltmeter, okay, you should take this reading. Vs means V2. Vp means V1. There is no need of Vp or V1. We are noting down just for verification, that's all. The PT ratio is X. X is 2 here. 440 by 220. So 2. And V2 or Vs, what you measure here, multiply by 2, you will get high value of the voltage. That is the primary voltage. And the secondary voltage is Vs. Okay, so Vs into X will be equal to Vp. Okay, both are same table. I have written 2 times. Okay, and in your syllabus, there is no one, A is not there. See, in 1 year, you are just verifying the PT ratio, finding the ratio of PT, just what you have done in your transformer experiment, finding voltage ratio of a transformer. That's all. You have already done this. In a transformer, have a voltmeter at primary and a secondary. Go on increasing the voltage of variac. Read both the readings, and then V2 by V1, you will get voltage ratio, or V1 by V2. Okay, that is not in your syllabus, but you should know that. So, this is regarding with experiment number 1.